So we know that our species, Homo sapiens, emerged in Africa. In the last few decades, the big discoveries have been coming from sites in South Africa that are on the coast or near the coast. So we found early evidence for innovative, symbolic, and technological behaviors that date to 105,000 years ago in the Kalahari, and that means that some of our ideas about the linkages between the emergence of Homo sapiens and coastal environments need to be rethought. This site is located on the southern edge of the Kalahari Desert in South Africa. The rock shelter is called Hamahana Hill. Many members in the local community use the shelter for prayer and ritual, and the area has a lot of spiritual significance. So recognizing and respecting that, our project has been adjusting our methods to make sure that we're not undermining those practices. We completely and carefully backfill our excavations in between every season, and would just do our best to leave almost no trace of having been there at all. We found 22 calcite crystals, and they're really well-formed and white and visually striking and lovely. And crystals around the world are really important for, you know, spiritual reasons or ritual reasons, different time periods and different places, and that's also true in Pleistocene South Africa. And we tried really hard to find out whether natural processes could explain how they got into the archaeological deposits, but there isn't an explanation. People must have brought them to this site. And we also found ostrich eggshell. And the ostrich eggshell at Hamahana shows all the signs of being collected by humans and not carnivores. The eggshell is strongly associated with artifacts, and in particular, bones that have been cut marked by humans, and a lot of them are burnt. Also, ostrich eggs are really good water containers, and they were used that way through Pleistocene and Holocene in South Africa. We also found that the environment 105,000 years ago was wetter than it is today. So this we know because of collaborations with researchers at the University of Cape Town. This is very much a collaborative, interdisciplinary, international project, and it's been really awesome for all of us to kind of come together with our different specialties and put all of this together. Our evidence in the Kalahari is much more supportive of models that consider different areas of the African continent all contributing to the emergence of our species. This innovation didn't happen first on the coast and then later get to the Kalahari.